What's up, YouTube? This is GroudonEmpire, and I am back for another episode of my Pokemon Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire Rating Battle Spot Single Laddering Series. Currently, I am doing different Mega Pokemon teams, and right now, this video is going to feature Mega Metagross. This is going to be part one. As is the case with all of my Mega Evolution mini-series, I have three parts, part one, two, and three, and I do a minimum of six games. And the first part is always has a little team summary, and then I have at least one game, most of the time one game, sometimes I have more than one game. And then in 2 and 3 I have the rest of the 4 or 5 games that I have to play. If you're interested in other Mega Evolution teams or just the content that I do after I was done doing all of these different Mega Evolution teams in the future, like if you're watching this way, way in the future, then definitely check out the playlist. Link is in the description for my Omega Ruby Alpha Sapphire Laddering series. If you're interested, maybe, you know, you want to see if I ever ended up getting super high or whatever in ORAS. And if you're interested in my series and how I ended up getting 1900 plus, or just the series itself, that's also in the description. That is Route Global 1000. It's also in the description, and I think that's enough for this. All right, so without further ado, I'm going to get right into a team summary. If you're not interested in the team summary, just skip on ahead a few minutes. If you are interested, I'm just going to start that right away. So as you guys can clearly see, well, almost completely clear, because Garchomp is just a Garchomp. Most Garchomps, viable Garchomps, are not going to be Mega Garchomp. Not that Mega Garchomp is bad or anything, but it's just that normal Garchomp is like a lot better. But yeah, this is a Mega Metagross team. Even normal Metagross is actually really good, but I don't really have any other Mega on the team, so I'm pretty obvious that Mega Metagross would be Mega on the team. Other than the fact that I said it. Alright, so Mega Metagross is the main Pokemon on this team. Now, when I first was making this team, I was thinking, I want to make a special Metagross. Because Mega Metagross, believe it or not, actually has a interesting special move set. Alright? Special biased mixed. With Tough Claws, Grass Knot gets boosted, and you have a workable 105 or 110 special attack stat. I don't know which one, but it's higher than Greninja's. That's all you need to know. It's higher than Greninja's, and you have Tough Claws boosted Grass Knot. And the significance of this is that you can actually kill off Slowbro. You can one-hit KO Slowbro with enough investment. Even without investment, you do like a gigantic chunk of damage. You can two-hit KO without investment. If you want to run physical biased mixed, you can even one hit KO Hippowdon with enough investment. And you always, pretty much always, one hit KO things like Quagsire. It's those are your typical walls that deal with Mega Metagross. And whether you're running a physically biased or a specially biased mixed set, if you have Tough Claws boosted Grass Knot, that's simply amazing, because those Pokemon, otherwise they wall you. And you need to have a Pokemon to deal with that. Such as my case, I have a Grass Knot Greninja of myself. I first thought of using that, especially because it also learns Icy Wind. And sure, it doesn't have access to better ice type moves, you know, but Icy Wind, it lowers opponent's speed. Not that it's really important, because you're already base 110 speed, but it's 4 times effective on so many Pokemon, and they're Pokemon that you can end up 2-hit KOing after Icy Wind, and then you can use another move afterwards. So that's actually amazing that I found on Mega Metagross. And I wanted to use that really badly, but then I figured if I ended up doing that, then I'll probably only use Mega Metagross to trick my opponents, and I never will actually use Mega Metagross how a normal Mega Metagross will end up being used, and Mega Metagross will probably get no limelight because of that. And so that's why I ended up using a physical Mega Metagross. So my Metagross is Jolly Max Speed and Attack. It has Ice Punch, it has Meteor Mash, it doesn't have Meteor Mash, it has Zen Headbutt, it has Bullet Punch, it has Ice Punch, and I think it has Earthquake. Yeah, does not have Meteor Mash, because I believe Meteor Mash is meh. Zen Headbutt is to kill off those what are those called? Those Venusaur. Bullet Punch is stab with Tough Claws, so I should be able to take on whatever I need to super effectively. Ice Punch and Earthquake are wonderful coverage. That's for that. Now, first teammate I thought of was Greninja. And why Greninja? Because Hippowdon, Slowbro, even Cresselia. Yes, Cresselia. I needed something to deal with those Pokemon. And also, Greninja's an amazing Mega Salamence tech just in case I ever need that thing, you know? Just in case. And it probably does other things that I can't think of at the top of my head right now. So, Greninja with Grass. I'm using Expert Belt, by the way. Naive Nature. I always use Naive because Hasty, at least you can take some kind of priority. Sometimes. Naive Nature, you don't need to care because, like, you're not really losing anything from your Naive Nature. So that's why I run Naive over Hasty. And I run Expert Belt. I don't run Focus Sash, even though Focus Sash is nice in this format, because 103 special attack, if you don't have a boosting item, it doesn't one-hit KO the things you want it to one-hit KO, even after rocks. And with Greninja in this format, you definitely don't want to factor in rocks for most things. And then I don't run Life Orb because I can get Life Orb stalled. So I figure I need to have Expert Belt so I can get the best of both worlds. You know, I don't get Life Orb stalled and I get the damage similar, but not, obviously it's not enough as Life Orb, but similar to Life Orb. So Dark Pulse can 2-hit KO Cresselia's. That's amazing. And because I'm not Life Orb recoil, I don't get Life Orb recoil, I can potentially destroy that thing 1v1, potentially. Especially if I get a flinch. And Slowbro and Quagsire go down to Grass Knot. Hippowdon goes down to Grass Knot. That's a nice list right there. I have Gunk Shot, so Fairies, Sylveon, Clefable, bye-bye. That's also another reason why I don't necessarily need Meteor Mash on Metagross either. Though again, Bullet Punch does do the job a lot of the time. And my last move is, did I say it? Ice Beam. Yep, I don't have Hydro Pump. Who needs Hydro Pump? I think Greninja is getting suspected right now in OU. So OU is different than 3v3. So don't just pass judgments between things in 3v3 and OU and whatnot just because you play OU a lot. 3v3 is a different monster, different format. Don't pass similar judgments. But yeah, I mean, who needs Hydro Pump? I personally don't care about Smogon bans and whatnot. I just play by the rules whenever I play by the rules. Whatever the rules are, that's just me. So whether it's banned or not, I don't really mind. Alright, so next Pokemon I have on my team is a Garchomp. I need rocks. Rocks is important. Breaking sashes all the time. Extremely important. Breloom's. I get 3-0'd by Breloom. If you didn't watch one of my past episodes, I got 3-0'd by a Breloom, and it was a lead Breloom. So Breloom is serious trouble. I have an Azumarill because I remember I told you guys you need a 1-2 offensive punch. Greninja is not a 1-2 offensive punch. Greninja is just there to deal with certain, it's just a secondary offensive Pokemon. But Azumarill is a very necessary 1-2 offensive punch because of the way it walls like so many Pokemon. It is amazing. Its typing is it's beautiful. And this is why using things like Sharpedo is like such a downgrade and such a makes your team so bad, because Azumarill is amazing. Now, I have Raikou because it sets up on Cresselia's and Porygon 2s, especially Porygon 2s, because Porygon 2s otherwise, depending on the matchup, I can use Azumarill or Raikou. It depends on what's cracking. And also it can set up on Aegislash. It's very interesting, by the way. If it's depending on the set, of course. And then I have a Talonflame for priority, because priority is priority. And you can never take priority for granted. You can never be wrong with priority. And in fact, if you don't have priority, you might be in the wrong, actually. So anyways, that's enough for this team summary. Hope you guys that stayed for the entire thing aren't super angry. Again, I always tell you in the beginning, you can skip on ahead if you're not interested in a team summary. So without further ado, I'm going to start with the challenges. Press the challenge button. Stylus doesn't like me. We are sitting at a 1,666. Amazing score. 666. What a beautiful number. And I don't have all the musics unlocked, but it doesn't matter because I'm not going to have the music blasting anyway. I can't do that anyway because it's risky for the channel and stuff. So I'm not going to do that. Don't be mad. Just appreciate the content. The battles. We found our opponent 1606. They're missing a 6 in the 10th place. 100th place, whatever. I don't know. I don't know my math anymore. Never did well in math, ever. Anyway, see my opponent's team. They have a Togekiss and they have a Machamp. Sorry about that. They definitely have a Mega Metagross. They definitely have a Gengar. I know for a fact that they have a Gengar. Because I know they have a Gengar, I want to start off with Talonflame. Because they might start off with the Gengar. What did I tell you guys? I want to start off with Talonflame. Because Talonflame is good versus Garchomp, Togekiss, Gengar. Machamp. I mean, I would start off with Garchomp, but I don't need to start off with... I mean, there's a potential Sasher in that Garchomp right there. But, I mean, again, I don't really need the Garchomp, I think. Maybe. You know what? I'm going to run Garchomp because I need the rocks. I need the rocks. Absolutely. Like, entirely. Raikou can deal with the Porygon, too. It can also deal with the Rotom Wash, because Rotom Wash is also a problem, guys. And Grass Knot doesn't actually deal with Rotom Wash. But I do have Zen Headbutt, though. But it might be bulky. It might burn me. Burns are never cool. Grass Knot doesn't deal with Rotom Wash. Unfortunately, it's, like, super annoying. I don't know why it doesn't, but it doesn't. Metagross can deal with Togekiss. It can also deal with Machamp. So why don't I use this thing? Why am I insisting on using Raikou? It's because I'll die to that Garchomp. But then I can use Azumarill. I can set up and destroy lives with Azumarill. I'm going to use Metagross because this is Metagross's team. I'm going to destroy the Togekiss and that thing. And then for the last Pokemon, I'm probably going to run a Raikou because it sets up on Porygon 2 and the Rotom Wash, hopefully. I just hope that Garchomp doesn't destroy my life because I have a very strong feeling that it will. I mean, I could have used Talonflame and I wanted to. But if I did that, then I had to pick homeboy Raikou. Gonna pick Metagross. Or I could've picked Azu. I could've picked Azu, but it's whatever. I'm gonna start off with the Rock Tomb because Rock Tomb's a nice move. And, I mean, seriously, I could've picked Azu. Why didn't I pick Azu? Whatever. Again, I'm focusing primarily, if I can use the Mega, I'm gonna focus. I went for a Rock Tomb predicting a switch or something along the lines, at least making it slower. And I don't know what the hell's gonna happen to me. I'm just gonna switch directly out. Do I wanna switch directly out? I know I want rocks. Man, screw this. Screw it, I don't want rocks. I'm just gonna switch out into Metagross. Because I know I know the Garchomp was there, but screw it all. As long as I can get that thing down to its sash, hopefully I should be alright. Predicted the Dazzling Gleam, that's why I switched out. Again, oh my god, he got a crit. Again, I could have used Raikou or Azumarill. I could have actually used Azumarill, actually, to set up nicely versus my opponent's team instead of using Raikou. But it's whatever. I mean, I can't do anything about it. I'm going to Mega Evolve, and I'm going to use a powerful, powerful Ice Punch because Bullet Punch does 72 damage after you factor in Tough Claws and Stab and everything. Wait, really? No. 40 plus 12, 52 plus stab, that's like 76 damage or something, and Ice Punch already does the same amount of damage. So I'm just gonna Mega Evolve and like go for a Zen Headbutt. I wanna go for a Zen Headbutt actually. I wanna Mega Evolve and go for a Zen Headbutt. Because he might have switched out into Gengar, maybe, and I didn't wanna take my risks. So that's why I went for a Zen Headbutt. And I hope I land, and I do land, so that's amazing. And it gets flinched, so that's also beautiful. I'll take that any day of the week. And right now, what I'm gonna do is I am just going to Ice Punch? Ice Punch? Do I want to Ice Punch? I want to Ice Punch. Yep. Alright, so the reason I use Zen Headbutt, I know it's risky, but the reason that I use Zen Headbutt was simply because if he switched out into Gengar, I need to make sure to damage that thing. He has a Rotom Wash. It's not fair. Come on. Well, that's why I have a Raikou, right? That's exactly why I have a Raikou. Right? Right, guys? Right?
Come on, tell me if I'm right or wrong, guys. Can't hear you.
Sorry, guys.
That's why I have a Raikou. What are you going to do? Thunderwave? Ooh, that worked so, so nicely in your favor. Now, I'm just going to use Substitute. Yep, I'm going to use Substitute. You're going to predict a Thunderbolt and go out into... Alright, so my opponent knows what's up, even though I don't have Hidden Power Ice.
I mean, once I broke the thing's sash, the Garchomp sash, Zen, not Zen Headbutt, Metagross could have cleaned it up, or I could have just, like, yeah, once I broke its sash, any of my other two Pokemon, I could have just bam bam, and Garchomp could also come in and do work, so that was nice. That was an excellent first game. Because of the time, I'm going to do another game, because usually I don't hit 15 minutes on the first video. I apologize for that. So I am just going to go into a second game. That was a very close, that was a very fast game, actually. That was a very, very fast game. So I'm a challenge, and right now I am going to pick the music one. I don't know how much it matters, but I'm going to do that. We're at 1679. Top 10 in the United States is 1700s. Though that doesn't really mean anything, but I mean, I guess if you want it to mean something, it means something. Really, it only matters, in my opinion, if you get top 1,000 in the world or top 1,000 in Japan, because sometimes only top 2 in the United States is equivalent to top 1,000 in the world. So that's why anywhere from top 2 to top 10 United States, it's I don't know. I don't know how much it matters. But top 5, when I finished top 5 in X and Y, that was equivalent to top 1,000 in the world. So that's why that meant something. But typically, it doesn't mean too much. But anyway, we see our opponent's team have a nice Lantern Gyarados. Oh my god, I hate their team. What do I do versus this team? Like, god. What do I do versus this team? I feel like... I need rocks for that Garchomp. Not Garchomp, man. For that Talonflame. So I want to set up rocks, and I feel like Azu can put in work. I mean, I know Raikou can set up on the Lantern and the Porygon too. And it can also put in work versus the what is that thing called? The Gyarados? But then Azu can set up on the what is that thing called? What is that thing called? Darn it, why can't I remember its name? Oh yeah, the Porygon 2. I can set up on the Porygon 2, and I can do good stuff to that Gyarados, and I can do big damage back to other things too. So I actually like Azu for this game. Like, I really, really, really like Azu for this game, actually. Greninja can put in work, but then it has to deal with problems too. I like Raikou for this game. It sets up on two things, and it can also destroy things too. But then there's that Lantern thing. I hate that Lantern thing. That Lantern thing is super, super annoying. I am going to use it, though. I'm going to use Raikou. Let's go with Raikou. Have rocks plus Raikou. I should be fine when I'm dealing with the Talonflame. And I cannot pick Metagross because Metagross is walled by Gyarados and pretty much everything except for Sylveon. So I have to pick Azumarill, Garchomp, Raikou, and Azumarill. Hope you guys understand why I did not pick Metagross. Again, this is not just for showcasing. It's primarily to use a team that I have to try to make a team because of my skill set, you know, 1900s plus in XY, my goal is to produce content where I actually make teams that are actually good. And this thing is the end of me. I can't set up on this thing if it has Power Whip. And it most likely does, unless it has Stealth Rock. In that case, it probably has Protect, Lead Seed, Stealth Rock, and a Gyro Ball, which I'm completely fine with, by the way. But I want to set up my own rocks right now because Talonflame's a pain in the crack. This Ferrothorn is probably going to be the end of me. I don't have a direct way of answering it because I don't have a Zapdos on my team. Oh, it has Knock Off. I can't set up with Raikou. My best bet is to just keep on using Earthquake. Right now, I am in gigantic trouble. I have to keep on using Earthquake right now. I have to weaken this thing. If I don't weaken this thing, I am doomed. I am doomed. I gotta do a calc right now. This thing is gonna be the end of me. So my focus is on making teams that are good, all right? But teams that allow me to actually use the Mega Pokemon as common, well, not common, but teams. I'm doing a calc, by the way, so mind me. I'm just going to talk right now. So I plan to use teams that allow me to use a Mega Pokemon that I want to use, and at the same time that they're actually at least, you know, all right, like at least a little good, you know what I mean? Come on, my thing has superpower. Give it superpower. Okay, how much damage? 62% damage, so I need to make sure to do a lot of damage with Earthquake. What is he gonna do now? All right, so I have to do as much damage as I can with Earthquake so superpower can actually kill. That wasn't a crit? All right, I'll take that all day. All day of the week. Oh, he's getting Rocky Helmet damage. Awesome. Sweet. Sweet sugar. And next turn, I'm just going to switch out into Mariko. Because, man, who am I kidding? I'm not switching out into Raikou. I'm just going to use another Earthquake. I don't know if he's going to switch out to Rotom something or something. But I'm just going to go for another Earthquake. Because I know he's going to sap my health and heal up and everything. But I need to do as much damage as I can to this thing. So, because I have Hidden Power Grass and Thunderbolt on Raikou, I need to make sure I can actually kill that thing off. I don't know how possible that's gonna be, but before I end up dying, I need to make sure I do that. And hey, I mean, he has Knock Off, and that's his only move. Protect, Lead Seed, Knock Off. Ooh, I can set up on him. All right, whatever. Protect, Lead Seed. Okay, he's probably brought in Talonflame. That's all right if he did. Oh, Porygon. All right, I see you. Right, I see you very loud and clear. All right, okay. It's interesting. I'm going to use Rock Tomb just in case this thing is speed creeping. Just in case it's speed creeping, I'm going to use Rock Tomb because it's going to recover stall me anyway. So I know I'm going to die. With my guard stomp anyway. But yeah, my focus is on making Mega Evolution teams with the new Megas, well, at the moment right now, right? But I want to actually use Mega as, like, as viable as I can, like, actually, like, do with it. Because not all Mega teams, you can actually end up using the Mega a lot of the times, right? Especially if you're focused on making a super awesome team for Battle Spot Single. I myself have made super awesome teams in the past when I was first making my teams. But then they weren't focusing on the Mega on hand. They were focusing on another Mega. So, and they're focusing on like other Pokemon. I was like, I can manage using a team that's not as good as long as I'm using the Pokemon. So that's why I ended up making different teams. Now, I feel like the Metagross team is actually pretty good. Don't get me wrong. I don't feel like it's a bad team. Again, don't. And I'm going to go into Azumarill right now because Ferrothorn, I cannot destroy Ferrothorn. Ferrothorn is an issue. A really big issue, actually. I'm going to go for a Belly Drum. I hope it doesn't have a Talonflame. Because if he does, all of my life, everything is gone. Everything. Everything I ever wanted to do in my life is gone. If he has a Talonflame. And I can't make that prediction. It's way too risky right now. Way, way too risky. Like, super way too risky. But with superpower and my Raikou intact, I feel like I can take my opponent on anyway. Okay, alright, never mind. I can destroy you regardless of anything and everything. I feel like I can do that anyway. Don't use Thunder Wave. I have a Citrus Berry. That's awesome. Citrus is going off. That's awesome. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. All right. So what do I want to do? What do I want to do with you? Physically defensive. You are a monster. I'm at plus six. I don't want to miss. I don't want to miss, but I'm going to use Play Rough. I'm going to go for the Play Rough. I don't want to miss, but I don't want my attack to drop either. And I can afford this little missing thingy-majiggy right now. Actually, I can't. Darn it. No, I'm at plus six. I'm at plus six. It should kill. It does kill. That's awesome. I only get Iron Barbs damage. No Rocky Helmet because we saw its leftovers. That's awesome. Zoom will put in work.
Azumarill putting in work. Alright, so, ooh, hoo, hoo. Talonflame. I know Talonflame's gonna kill me off. I just need to make sure that I have my Raikou intact. And everything in the world is fine after that. Again, I'm not going to go for an Aqua Jet because I need to go into Raikou. I know I used my Citrus Berry already and I used Belly Drum and everything, but I have to make this play. I really do. I'm at plus 6. My opponent shouldn't use Will-O-Wisp. If they do Will-O-Wisp, I'm going to be crying like a little baby. Alright, they didn't use Will-O-Wisp, so we are in nice shape. And I am just going to Thunderbolt because I don't know what else to do with myself. I honestly don't. Should I go for a substitute? What? Yo, screw this. I'm gonna go for a substitute. I'm gonna go for a substitute because even if he's like Will-O-Wisp or Flare Blitz, like I can still kill him off. Okay, I see you. I should have used Thunderbolt. What's wrong with me? Whatever. I'm just gonna use Calm Mind once that other thing comes in anyway. He has to switch out now. If he uses Roost, I think I do big damage to him anyway. So it's whatever. He's gonna use Brave Bird. He's not going to break my sub. As we saw, it does like 10% damage or 15. Yeah, he's not gonna break my sub. And I'm going to kill him off with a Thunderbolt, and then I'm going to set up my Calm Mind. So finally, Raikou's putting in work in a game. If you guys didn't know, last three episodes, I did use Raikou, but it didn't come in a single game. awesome. So yeah, again, as I was saying, I keep on going off away from what I was saying. I want to make different Mega Pokemon teams that I'm doing, and focus on winning. Again, I need, like, competitive content, is focusing on winning. So winning is an important part of, you know, everything, you know, so I have to be winning. You know, if I'm not winning, then can I use Calm Mind? Nope. Okay. So winning is important. You know, that's part of being competitive. If you're not trying to win, you're not being competitive. There's no such thing as casual competitive. There's no such thing as a little competitive. There's no such thing as any of that stuff. Will Foul Play destroy my sub? That did a lot of damage, I can tell you that much. Foul Play, Recover, Toxic, and some other bananas. It's fine, Recover. It's fine, I'll just keep on using Thunderbolt. And I don't think Foul Play is gonna tear me up. No, he was Toxic. I'm going to use Calm Mind right now because I need to, like, do damage to this Porygon 2 before I end up going down. This Porygon 2, darn it. I should have switched out. What is wrong? Oh my goodness, I should have switched out. I played this thing terribly. I thought I won this. I played this thing absolutely terribly. Like, the worst. Right, as long as I use Calm Mind next turn, then I can use Thunderbolt freely. I think, hopefully. Alright, so this is actually pretty darn intense. I hope that things go well right now because I cannot afford to lose this. That did a lot of damage. I think that's gonna break my sub actually. No, that's not gonna break my sub. That did 15, that did 5%. I don't know, but I'm just going to use Thunderbolt because I need to kill this thing. I seriously do as much damage as I possibly can to this thing. It's going to use Recover. It's going to use Recover. That's alright. It's alright because I'll just keep on using Thunderbolt. Hopefully good things happen. That's He's definitely going to do something crazy versus me. Oh, man. I can't use Foul Play with Azumarill. Alright, so I'm going to have to hopefully paralyze this guy before I go down. Darn it. I should have switched out when I was taunted. Because I can 1v1 this thing. I just need to make sure I'm not taunted. I should have sacked off the Azumarill. I played this terribly. If I end up losing, it is my own fault. Because I played this extremely bad. Extremely poorly. If I do Belly Drum, my opponent can easily just kill me off. Like, easily kill me off with a Foul Play. Because I don't have a Citrus Berry with me anymore. So what I am going to do is, I'm just going to play rough. I have to hope that he doesn't, I don't know what to hope for. I honestly don't. I don't know what to hope for. But I'm just going to play rough. I just hope I don't miss. He's going to Foul Play. And I can't use Belly Drum anymore. If I use Superpower, that's going to do 45. And the next turn, it's going to do 30. That's 70%. But then he's going to... I just need to get a crit with the Play Rough. And I think I'm in good shape. If I can get a crit with the... No, I need to get a crit with the Superpower. Darn it, this stinks. This stinks so bad. Come on. I had this in the bag. I still have a chance though. Play Rough is doing a good amount of damage. Man, he's gonna stall me out of Play Roughs. Darn this thing, man. This is so frustrating. Whatever, I'm just gonna keep on using Play Rough, and then at the end, I'm just gonna keep on using... Okay, how much damage does Play Rough do? That does 20, so I only have 3 more tries. I only have 2 more Play Roughs anyway. So, it's alright. Honestly is alright. I only have 1 more Play Rough left to use. This thing gets all the HP back. That's crazy. I just hope I land the... Yeah, I finally missed one. And he's gonna take the win home. I'm gonna use a superpower. I hope I get a crit next turn. Oh my goodness, I got a well-timed crit. If only Foul Play doesn't kill, then I win this. Alright, we win this game. So... I could have won this game to begin with if I just switched out my Raikou into Azumarill, sacked it off, and ended up coming back out with the Raikou, setting up a sub and Calm Mind, all of that good stuff. But in the end, because he didn't have Thunderbolt and he had Foul Play, basically all I had to do was to keep on using Play Rough, get at least one crit, all right? And I kept on using Play Rough, all right? And you guys saw that I got my miss before a crit. And that's what, you know, you guys saw that happen. So when you're doing the move like multiple times, you're gonna eventually see a crit and a miss. And you saw a miss. And then I ended up using superpower and I finally got a crit after so many turns. So that's a problem with relying on bulk sometimes, is that happens. And I've been on my fair share end of getting crit while I was calm minding and just getting destroyed. So I know how that feels, but at the same time, when you're using bulky mons, that's something you have to deal with. And I played it wrong with the Raikou, but I could have won that game anyway. So ending up winning like that is great. That's awesome. I'll take that win any day of the week, because I was supposed to win with the Raikou if I just played it better anyway. And
hopefully I don't make mistakes like that in part 2 and part 3. If you enjoyed this episode, please remember to click that like button, share this video, and subscribe to the channel. Also, keep in mind, there is a part 2 and a part 3, so definitely check those out, as well as the other stuff on this channel. Check out the channel, the uploads, the playlists in the description as well. This is GroudonEmpire. Peace out.